Hello and welcome. So my name is Diego Palacios. I am the founder and president of DAMA Peru chapter. And well, first I would like to start by thanking our sponsors. Of course, without them, planning this type of webinars and events will be impossible, planned properly. Thank you very much, Universidad Tecnológica del Perú, Power Data Perú, Carrera de Ingeniería Empresarial Universidad Continental, and of course, Anjana Data. Thank you for your support and collaboration. This is our second international webinar organized and hosted by DAMA Peru. And today we have a special speaker. Today we have Irina Steenbeek, Dr. Irina Steenbeek. And Irina is a data management expert with more than 10 years of experience in this data management field. And she main expertise and key professional experiences in data management frameworks and of course in data lineage solution. So I'm going to be your host today for this event. And thank you very much, Irina, for being here with us. So it's a pleasure to host an event with you as a main speaker. And Irina, the show is yours.
Good day, good afternoon, everybody. Thank you for joining us today. As you told, my name is Irina Steenbeek, and it's a great opportunity to meet, even if you're only you who can see me, and unfortunately, I can't see you, but I hope we will manage somehow more or less interactive communication. First, I'd like to thank DAMA Peru and personally Diego for this event. And today's topic is using maturity models in data management practices. What, why, and how? Let me briefly introduce myself. I've been working in data management for over 11 years. I've published 4 books and I've written more than 50 articles. Several years ago, I established Data Crossroads. Data Crossroads is a coaching and training enterprise specializing in data management. And as Diego said, the key area of expertise are data management maturity models and assessment, setting up data management frameworks, and the development of data lineage business cases. And now let's move to the presentation. The only what I'd like to ask you, I'll give this presentation for maybe 40, 45 minutes, and I hope by the end you might have some questions. So feel free, ask your questions, and we will have some sort of Q&A session for that. So in this presentation, I will address several key questions. The first of which is, what is the data management maturity model? The second, why do we need to measure maturity? And the final question, how can we measure the maturity? I'll spend most of the time discussing the third question, the most practical one. So let's start with the first question, what? We'll agree on the definition of maturity and we'll investigate the key criteria that identify a maturity model. Then we will briefly discuss the existing models of data management and we'll take a look at the definition of data management framework. I always start any discussion with the definition of the topic. It ensures that we are speaking the same language and that we understand each other properly. I found several definitions of maturity. The one which I like the most, I put as the header of the slide. Maturity is a measurement of the ability of an organization to undertake continuous improvement in a particular discipline. This definition assists us in defining the key components of a maturity model. I've chosen the keywords of the definition: particular discipline, continuous improvement, ability, and measurement. And I've also linked these words to the key components of a data management maturity model. Particular discipline is data management. Of course, the term data management can have different meanings in different contexts, which we'll discuss later. Maturity levels reflect continuous improvement. The number of hierarchies of building blocks represent the ability. I use a business capability model by the Open Group, and I will elaborate on this model later on. Assessment criteria help in measuring maturity. On this slide, you see the summary of what we just discussed. A data management maturity model should be comprised of four elements: maturity levels, building blocks and their hierarchies, assessment criteria, and assessment methodology. I'll use this model in this presentation for two purposes. The first is to compare existing maturity models, because as you may know, there are plenty of different maturity models. The second use is to demonstrate how to use maturity models in data management practices. For that, I'll use the orange model of maturity that I explore in my practices. If you speak about the maturity of data management, we should agree what data management is. I know from my practice that everybody may have their own understanding of these words depending on the context. I spent a lot of time analyzing the two key data management models, Dama-Danbok, and I'm sure that everybody who are here knows this model, and DECAM, Data Management Capability Assessment Model by the Enterprise Data Management Council. I came to the challenging conclusions. These two models have significant differences, and they represent different viewpoints on data management. Let's briefly discuss the differences in the models. First of all, the list of data management building blocks. DAMA uses knowledge areas as the key business blocks. DECAM operates with components, capabilities, and sub-capabilities. Even from the first look, you can see that the number and names of the blocks differ. DAMA has 11 knowledge areas, and DECAM has 8 components, 38 capabilities, and 136 sub-capabilities. One of the most important differences is the relationship between data management and information technology. According to DAMA, data management is a part of IT domain. DECAM considers information technologies as a part of the collaborative environment. The relations between IT and data management had also brought me to the understanding of differences in approaches to data management between DAMA and DECAM. DAMA takes a look at data management from a broad perspective. DAMA considers data management from the point of view of the life cycle of data circulating in a company. DECAM's narrow perspectives consider data management from the viewpoint of tasks to be performed by data management professionals. These differences in approaches specify differences in the content of data management. Using this slide, I'll share with you my interpretation of data management. This is one of the diagrams of the orange model I've developed. The story behind this picture is interesting, and I'd like to share it with you. Once I was asked to explain in 15 minutes how to implement data management using DAMA. Even for data management professionals, the DAMA model is not easy to understand. The knowledge areas belong to different subject areas. Some of them are devoted to data types, for example, master, reference, metadata. But then I have a question: where is the transactional data? Other differences or challenges, from one side we have type of data, but then we have some sort of IT capabilities like integration architecture or data modeling and something like that. So when I got this request, finally, after 6 years of working with DAMA model, I found a way to easily explain it. If you take a look at the picture, data and information resources are the core subject of data management and this block located in the center. Data has quality, data quality. Enterprise architecture describes, classifies, models, and designs data and information. With enterprise architecture, I mean business, data, application, and technology architecture. Of course, business architecture has no direct relation to data, but still it's useful to apply its techniques. Data governance or data management framework is the last component of the data management from the narrow viewpoint. You'll recall that the narrow viewpoint represents the view on data management from the data management related tasks. All boxes marked orange here represent the narrow viewpoint. The enterprise architecture has double color, is half orange. It's because that application and technology architecture belongs to the IT domain. The rest of data management components belongs to the broad perspective of data management and colored gray. Enterprise architecture designs IT technology architecture and security. IT implements security and information technologies enables the life cycle of data and information resources. Security enables the security of data and information assets. And data governance coordinates data management related activities with IT and security function. In my experience, the majority of large international companies understand data management in a narrow scope. The most common data management sub-capabilities are those that are marked orange: data governance, data quality, data modeling, data architecture, and data assets management. I'll come back to this model later on because I'll use it for comparison of different maturity models. Now, I'd like to agree with you on the definition of data management use, yeah? Because the topic of our presentation today, how we can use maturity models in data management practices. But what is data management practices? What do we mean by that? In my opinion, the key goal of the practices is to establish a data management framework or data management function. Let me briefly share with you my vision on this concept. I take the following approach. A data management framework is a collection of interrelated components. And these components are needed to establish data management function and achieve data management goals. Models and methods are these key components. So model is simply representation of something, such as a physical object, process, phenomenon, etc. And method is a way of doing something according to a specific order of activities. The framework serves the following purposes: design of data management function, implementation, measurement maturity, and maintain and monitor the effectiveness. So the measurement of maturity should be embedded into the process of establishment of data management framework. This slide represents the method that I call the data management star. This method is also part of the orange data management framework. This framework is a ready-to-use, step-by-step guide to implement data management. The current version includes 7 phases. We start with the scoping of data management framework. Then we need to perform a preliminary data management assessment. Then we design and implement the framework. And when it's done, then a company should perform an extended data management maturity assessment. In my presentation, I will demonstrate both methods, preliminary and extended assessment methods. Now, we will take a brief look at the reasons to use a maturity assessment. I heard different opinions from data management professionals about maturity assessments. Some of them haven't seen any use. Others like the idea. In my opinion, the advantage of using maturity assessment for data management seems pretty obvious. Each company manages data in one way or another. Some companies have already formalized the data management function. Others have not. Regardless of this, any company can still measure its data management maturity. A maturity assessment serves two purposes. On the left side, you can see the first one, the first purpose is improvement of performance. And you do it in several steps. The first step, you assess the situation as is, so where you are. Then you define a to-be status that should be achieved within a defined period. The difference between these two statuses highlights the gaps. And then you identify practical steps to fill in the gaps and reach to-be status. A good data management maturity model should assist in performing all of the steps. The second reason is to benchmark the results of your company with peers in the industry. It would be also great if a maturity model can provide such a benchmarking. And now it's time to move on and discuss the key question, how to use maturity models in data management practices. In this part, we'll discuss four topics. First, we will compare the existing maturity models. Then I'll present the five-step methodology to perform an assessment. I'll use the orange maturity model that I'm using in my practices, but this method can be used for any model you're going to use in your practices. And at last, I'll demonstrate how to perform preliminary and extended maturity assessment. And I'll share with you two business cases. Plenty of different data management and governance maturity models exist. So assume a company wants to measure its maturity. How do you choose the right one, the right model? What criteria should this model satisfy? For this presentation, I've chosen six models for comparison. You see it on the left side of the slide. There are three data management maturity models. It is DAMA DAMBOK by DAMA International, DICAM, Data Management Capability Assessment Model by the Enterprise Data Management Council, CMMI, Data Management Maturity Model. There are also two models for data governance, IBM and Stanford. And the last one is Enterprise Information Management by Gartner. Several months ago, I placed a poll on LinkedIn to check the usage statistics of these models. You can see this picture in the center. In this figure, you can see the results based on 93 votes done internationally worldwide. You can see that DAMA is the champion. DICAM is the second leading framework for assessing maturity. And this is a very interesting result. DICAM has been originally targeted for financial institutions. It seems that DICAM has become a more generic framework. But still, around 8% of respondents adjust existing models or develop their own. So based on the statistics, you can see that all models I mentioned have been used by companies. What I can't say is how the companies make their choice. What I can do is to demonstrate differences and commonalities between these models. Maybe such a comparison will explain the choices made by companies. Now we face a challenge to compare these models. If you recall, we agreed on the key components of a maturity model, and this is the first column of this table. These are maturity levels, building blocks, assessment criteria, and methodology. I've used these components to make a comparison. One of the key challenges to perform the comparison is the accessibility of information. You can easily get information only about the DAMA approach. It's described in DAMA publications. The information about the rest of models is not much publicly available. So I only can deduct some features of the models from very limited open sources. I am not going to dive into detailed comparison, but you can easily see the key differences. First, some models assess data management. Others assess data governance. Gartner models speaks about enterprise information management. But at the same time, these models cover similar areas. For example, data governance, data quality are present in each model. So it means that the definition of data management and data governance are not aligned between different models. For example, initial ad hoc level by DAMA is level one, so it's second level in row, while the CAM put ad hoc level to the level zero. So it means that the same company can get different maturity levels using different models. The next difference is the nature and number of building blocks. DAMA has 11 knowledge areas. DECAM operates with 8 components, 38 capabilities, and so on. You can see that other models speak about processes, somebody speak about components, and what is interesting, even if DECAM and Gartner speak about capabilities, the definitions behind these capabilities are quite different. So each model describes data management using different building blocks. The most unclear feature of each model is the assessment criteria and the underlying assessment methodology. For example, DAMA recommends assessing the maturity of each knowledge area using 5 dimensions: processes, tools, standards, people, resources. DECAM assesses each sub-capability. For every approach, 2 questions remain. The first one, how to assess the maturity level for each criterion? And the second question, how to aggregate the results to a higher level of abstraction? So the methodology remains a mystery. The last challenge, which you can't see, is the difference in the content of building blocks. For example, the content of data governance in DAMA differs greatly from DECAM models. And I'll demonstrate these differences at the next slide. I know that the slide may look scary, and I'm not going to discuss it in detail. Those who are interested can read some of my publications. The key message here is the following. The content of data management governance building blocks differs greatly between different models. I'll briefly explain the content of this slide. For the comparison, I used the simplified model of data management I discussed a couple of slides before. I hope you recall it, data assets and their center, technology, enterprise architecture, and so on. I took the chosen 6 maturity models, you can see it on the left side of the slide, and I mapped their building blocks to the schema. Even visually, without diving into the content, you see a great variety of business blocks. It means that different maturity models have different viewpoints on data management. So the key question, how can a company choose the model that meets the company needs? And I think the question is really challenging. The comparison of different maturity models has led to several conclusions. First conclusion is difficult to compare the maturity models. They have substantial differences. These differences you find in each comparison criteria: number and names of maturity levels, the number and nature of building blocks, and so on. This challenge leads to the next one. To make a proper maturity assessment, the model of data management should be aligned with the maturity model. For example, a company uses DAMA for the implementation of data management. It will be totally logical to use the DAMA approach for the maturity assessment. Assume a company chooses another model. Then a complex mapping should be performed first. I don't want to diminish the value or usability of each of these models. My opinion about maturity models can be expressed with the idiom, every tech has his Jill. Still, a company could experience difficulties in choosing the right model. And the last significant challenge is the inability to benchmark results with peers in industry. Now we will speak about the 5-step method. So how you are going to perform a data management maturity assessment. So the challenges that I just mentioned gave me the idea to develop the approach to perform a maturity assessment. Assume a company decides to perform the maturity assessment. It can use one of the existing models. It can also design its maturity model. In any case, a company needs to perform 5 general steps. The first step is to identify the data management model they use. The model includes data management building blocks, their structures, and the key deliverables. The second step is to identify the chosen maturity model. At this step, you identify the also building blocks, assessment criteria, key performance indicator, and the assessment methodology. During the third step, these two models should be mapped. The key challenge is to choose how to map them and at which level of abstraction. Assume a company uses the DAMA DMBOK model of data management, and DAMA includes 11 knowledge areas, and company decides to make a maturity assessment using the DCAM model, and I know such companies. This model has 8 components, 38 capabilities. How are you going to map these models? At which level? A couple of months ago, I completed such exercise and I mapped the deliverables of DAMA model with sub-capabilities of DCAM. And I'll demonstrate one example later on. So let's continue with the steps. So after the step 3, when you perform the map between data management model with data management maturity, the next step will be to assess as is status and to be status. The final step is to perform a gap analysis and make plans to achieve the to be situation. I'll show you how you can perform the steps in practice using the orange model. We'll start with step 1, specify a data management model. As I just said, I'll use the orange model for data management for the demonstration. The orange model is the development of data crossroads, and people think that the name orange is because I live in the Netherlands. That's not the case. When I first made a comparison of various data management and data management maturity models, I got a feeling that I had compared peers with apples. I decided to develop a hybrid approach to overcome these challenges. I've developed the model. And I was looking for the name of the model. I've decided to use the name of a hybrid fruit as the analogy of the goal of this new model. To my surprise, I found that the orange fruit is a hybrid of mandarin and pomelo, so the orange model was born. Let's take a quick look at the model. Everything starts with business and its model. The business delivers value to its customers. You can use different methods to describe the business model. Here you see Porter models, but you can also use business canvas or model of business capabilities or model, whatever you like. The orange model defines data management as a business capability. I've used the business capability model by the Open Group. What is a business capability? Business capability is the ability of a company to reach some goals and deliver outcomes. The same goes for data management. Data management designs and implements data chains. And data chains transform data into information. And a set of data management sub-capabilities enables the functioning of data chains. Data management framework, data quality are examples of such capabilities. Each company should identify its scope of data management and the set of required capabilities. You can see that I've put some other capabilities as examples. Each data management sub-capabilities played a particular role at some steps of a data chain. For example, data modeling capability delivers data requirements and data models. This capability is required at two stages of data chain. Four dimensions describe each sub-capability, and these dimensions are similar to what DAMA provides. In my model, it's role, process, data, and tools. Let's take as example a data modeling capability. Data models are the key outcomes. To design a data model, a company should have processes in place. A data modeler is a role that performs processes and delivers data models. A data modeling tool will enable the design of data models. So every company should know and document a data management model it uses. The documentation should include the key building blocks and the way how you describe them. The orange model is only example. I know that majority of you are users of DAMA. So the same happened to DAMA. You need to identify which knowledge areas you're going to use, which deliverables you're going to deliver, each knowledge area should deliver, and so on. Now we can continue with step two, because step two requires that you identify the data management maturity model and its key components. If you recall, we agreed on four key components: building blocks, assessment criteria, assessment methodology, and maturity levels. I'll demonstrate these components for the orange model. Building blocks of the maturity model are aligned with data management. So as I said, these are five standard or basic building blocks: data chain, data modeling, information system architecture, data quality, and data management framework. Role, process, data, and tool describe each of these sub-capabilities. Each of these dimensions can be detailed into an item level. For example, you can speak about the data management roles as a whole, but you can also say, okay, I'd like to assess whether we have data modeler role. Yeah, this is the way everything depends on the goal of your maturity model or your maturity assessment. The next component of data management maturity model is the assessment criterion. You can assess the maturity criterion on different level of abstraction. You can do it at higher level or you can do it at a lower level. What is interesting, for each of the dimensions, you can assign five statuses. The statuses are doesn't exist, informal, in design, in implementation, and operational. You can apply these statuses for every dimension. So you can say, for example, the role doesn't exist, or informal, or in design. The process doesn't exist, informal, in design. I hope you got the idea. The assessment methodology is simple. You calculate the average assessment for each data management sub-capability, and then for the whole data management capability. So this approach is really about the measurement and the not subjective perception. In this slide, I want to show you how you can describe each sub-capability using four dimensions. I'll use the data modeling capability as an example. Let's first start with the data outcome. I list the common outcomes of this capability. Data models, data requirements, business glossaries are examples. Only some of these deliverables can be marked as a key performance indicators. In this example, I've chosen data requirements, conceptual models, and business dictionaries as key performance indicators. To deliver these outcomes, related business processes should be in place. For example, to develop a business glossary, I'll need a process. How to design, document, and maintain a business glossary. So I again mark these processes as KPIs. To deliver these outcomes and perform these processes, I need to set up data management roles. So this is the next KPI which I choose. To design a data model, I also need a tool. This is the last KPI. So the relations are simple. Process delivers an outcome. A role performs a process. Tool enables a process, and so on. So you can do such an exercise for each data management capability at different level of details. Let's come back to the process of data management maturity assessment. Step three is the mapping between data management and data management maturity model. In the case of the orange model, I don't need to perform it. The same model has been used for both purposes. For example, a company that uses DAMA for both purposes also can escape this step. But assume a company uses DAMA as a data management model and wants to perform the maturity assessment by applying DICAL methodology. I've written a series of articles in which I have compared the DAMA and DICAL. Believe me, mapping between these two models was a challenging exercise. The most challenging was to find the comparable assessment criteria. I took the deliverables from the DAMA Dambok and adjusted sub-capabilities from DICAL. An example of such mapping you can see in this slide. I demonstrate you the easiest mapping between data quality components of two models. And you still can see that some of the deliverables don't match. With other components, the mapping was much more complicated and not straightforward. So if you're interested, you can read of one of my several articles on this site. Just now we continue with the step number 4 and 5 of maturity assessment. First, you perform as-is situation. Then you identify the desired to-be status. You should identify when you want to reach to-be status. Gap analysis demonstrates the differences between these statuses. For each item in gap analysis, you identify action plans. These actions should be performed within an identified period. This methodology works for different periods. It can be 3 months, then you identify a project plan. It can be a year, then you design a roadmap. It can also be a several year period, then you may come up with a strategy and strategic plans. The level of detail depends on the goals and the period. You can do assessment at different levels of abstractions. Here, I demonstrate a technique called heat mapping, and I promised you to stress to describe two different approaches for maturity assessment, preliminary assessment. And this heat mapping exactly the example of such preliminary assessment at high level of abstraction. It's very efficient to use during workshop. The way how it works, you identify different statuses, you give them different colors. For example, doesn't exist is red. And you simply compare where you are, you describe where you are. For example, here you see today we don't have any processes for data modeling, but in 1 year to deliver some outcomes, we need to design these processes and start their implementation. So this is the way how you can make at high level of abstraction preliminary data management maturity assessment. I'd like to share with you some very interesting and challenging experience. It demonstrates that the maturity assessment should have a clear goal and scope. Once I delivered a workshop to a team of 20 professionals of a large international company. The group has included business data stewards, data architects, and IT professionals. They have simultaneously delivered several data quality projects within one business domain. We've decided to assess the data quality capability for three different data quality projects. We have all been very surprised by the results. The maturity levels of data quality capability differed greatly for different projects. For example, for one project, business processes haven't been fully operational, while in another project, they didn't even exist, and so on. So the conclusion is obvious. The measurement of maturity should have a clear goal, and the goal will define the scope, the approach, and the assessment criteria. Now I want to demonstrate you the second case, which I promised. A couple of years ago, I designed a simple data management maturity scan. Initially, it was designed as a marketing tool. It's based on the Orange model, it's free of charge, it's anonymous, and it's accessible at the Data Crossroads site. To my surprise, within 7 months of 2019, 63 companies worldwide have completed this test. I made an analysis, and the results have matched what I've seen in practice. During 2020, around 300 companies performed the scan again. As such, I decided to compare the results between 2019 and 2020. The results were fully consistent. The key conclusion is that the level of data management maturity has grown worldwide. So in this presentation, I'll demonstrate some results, but at my site, you can download free of charge data management maturity review for 2019 and 2020. So what you can see here on the slide is that level one is the lowest level and level five is the highest. So you can see that no respondents have demonstrated the lowest level of overall data management maturity. The percentage of companies at level two has decreased. Yeah, so their low level, less companies remain on the low level. And at the level three, the percentage of respondents has grown. So this my key conclusion that the situation with data management worldwide became better. At the next slide, you can see the same results, aggregated capability dimensions. Here you can see data quality, data value chain, data management frameworks, and data modeling. So I don't describe it in detail anymore, but if you're interested, you can always come back to my site and see this in detail. So here you see also one example of one KPI. It's data management policy and processes. And here you also can see the improvement with the situation of data management policies worldwide. So a short conclusion, if you will be interested, you can make this maturity scan at my site and you can download the assessment review also on my site, and you can see the links here. And I think this is the end of our presentation. It's exactly 45 minutes, as I promised. At the end, I'd like also to share with you, I told that I've written 4 books. And this is my books. Three of them goes about the implementation of data management frameworks. It's Data Management Cookbook, Toolkit, and the Orange Model. And in a couple of months, I'll publish my new book, is Data Lineage from Business Perspective. It's very complex concept. So if you're interested, you can follow new developments. And now I think we can start. Oh, it's really very interesting. I can't see the Q&A session. It disappears somehow. No idea why. It's very strange. But thank you very much for your attention. And we are ready to start with the questions.
Thank you very much, Irina, for your presentation. It's very interesting this point of view of data management is very interesting. So of course, as you know, in this audience, you will find a lot of DEMA framework practitioners, and I'm one of them. So I've been practicing this, the DEMA framework for data management, and of course the data maturity model since 10 years. And for example, in the DEMA framework maturity model, so you will find like five levels, right? From ad hoc initial up to optimize, for example. And in my experience, for example, when we start, and this, as you mentioned, also all these maturity models are one of the main audience will be the data management professionals. But what will be your advice if, for example, the executive members, the executive group, want to skip these levels of maturity? Because as you know, as we understand, always business wants to have, you know, outcomes as soon as we can. What would be your advice for that, Irina?
It's very simple. You know, you need to speak with every audience, you need to speak different languages. Because everything what I demonstrated here is for data management professionals. It's detailed. But when you go to executives, you need to be very short. And you need to say, why are you doing something? What are the key pains? Yeah? You can't come and say, hi guys, we have a problem with data management. Because what data management is? Yeah, we have every company, the challenge is that every company has data management, even if they don't have data management function in place.
Right.
So you need to show, okay, we have challenges. I even don't say problems. We have challenges with data quality. It caused some challenges for our company. We lose some money and we are not at proper level. Yeah. So finally, this is the story that you need to demonstrate at very high level. And here you can say, you know, we don't have processes in place and we have lack of some professionals. And this is the level you should speak about. And this is what it's finally DAMA model. Use the same five dimensions. Yeah, the strategy, et cetera, et cetera. I use four. But everything goes about the same. Processes, deliverables, roles, and tools. And this is the level at which you should speak about your executives. But why? Yeah, why?
The why first.
Why first, yeah. And what the second, what they will get if it will become better.
This is
totally. And then you start saying, you know, we don't have people, we don't have something like that.
Yeah, totally agreed. So in my experience, talking about this, like data management topic with executive, it's a little, we go more in detail. So it could be a little challenge. It could be a challenge, of course. So sure. My experience, of course, I did this summary with like strengths, gaps, and recommendations. And for this type of audience, totally agree. So let's see the questions in the chat. So we have from Juan, what is the main focus of organizational and cultural change in data management framework? So what, based on your experience, what will be the main focus? And for example, if we talk about cultural change or cultural in the organization.
I'll come back to your first question, executives, because we all need to understand data management, you're not doing it for fun. Yeah? And it's very expensive exercise, finally. And it's not one project. It's forever. If you're going to establish data, formal data management framework, it's forever. So finally, the key challenge and change in culture is to involve different stakeholders, because this is also one of the principles which Dama says here. Data management needs assistance or need involvement of everybody. But the key problem that executives are to be involved at the first people. Yeah, they should be sponsors of the data management initiative. Because without having resources, you can't really do it properly. So finally, cultural change, everybody needs to start speaking about data and data management. That's
totally
all.
Agree. Mm-hmm.
Because finally, everybody within the company is working with data, nothing else.
Right. Yeah. So let me check. Well, yeah, we have Mr. Peter Aiken. It's a pleasure to have you in the audience, of course. Very soon we'll have you here as main speaker too. And we have another question from Andre Hill. So how do you perform as an assessment with Data DM Book? Because Data DM Book don't have assessment tool. I'm talking. Okay, so well, I can first give my impression about this. So yeah, in the thank you, Mr. Peter. So in the DEMA framework, you will have this DEMA data management maturity framework tool. So of course, you're not going to find like a final receipt there. Based on my experience, it's going to be difficult to find like a manual step one, step two, step three. But you will find like this framework. You will have these levels of maturity, and you will have, of course, based on your use case and your reality, you will have to focus first in the process, as Rina mentioned. And then you will have to ask the right questions in order to measure in which step, and as Irina mentioned, in order to measure your AC situation, right? That will be my recommendation, Irina.
Yeah, sure. You know, the challenge with DAMA, they do provide rules how to build data management assessment, data management maturity assessment. But this is a challenge with DAMA. Yeah, I know DAMA for 11 years. I use this model. It's very good knowledge publications, but to bring it into practice, you need to do a lot of yourself. That's why I wrote all my books, because you know I started data management really 11 years ago without having no knowledge. Consultant came to me and said, you know, we need to implement data management, I don't know what it is. Let's go and look at it. And I start Googling. It's not a joke, it's true.
Yeah.
I came across, and it's funny, I came across the DAMA wheel, and I didn't know for 6 years that DAMA had a book. So I created myself all practices based on information gathered from Google and implemented into practice. So finally, this orange model I spoke about and all of my books is simply practical implementation or demonstration of practical experience, how you can do stuff. So you can take a DAMA and start doing it yourself. You can, yeah.
Yes, yeah. Yeah, that's a lesson learned, yeah?
Yeah.
Great. So okay, Andre, I see. The DM Book 2 version 2 has their own topic and their own knowledge area about data maturity assessment.
Yeah.
So, thank you very much, Peter. So yeah, it was a pleasure also to have you in the audience. So I don't know if we have more questions from the audience. I'm not seeing more questions here. So, yeah. So a final maybe recommendation, Irina, to our audience.
Final recommendation, get fun from data management, because for me it's not professional. It's not professional, it's really a hobby. I really enjoy it, and also by one reason, every day you come to a job or you start doing something and you got some unexpected events. Yeah, sir. This is one of the challenges, but I like it. So simply do it, you know. Data management is not a theory. First, you have to be involved in practice, and then you can somehow summarize it in some models. Yeah, it's exactly what I am doing. I do stuff, and then I create models to explain other people my experiences. So enjoy it.
Perfect. So thank you very much for all the participants for being here in our webinar. So, and thank you very much, Rina, for your time and for your excellent presentation.
Thank you, Diego. It was a pleasure of me. Unfortunately, I couldn't see people, but I really enjoyed at least communicating with you and answering some questions.
Perfect. Thank you very much. Okay. Gracias a todos por conectarse. Adiós. Chao. Thank you very much. Bye.
Bye.